gets it back. DeBrusk is on him. Jake DeBrusk, number 74. Forward with a little pass that the Rangers take back. And score! Nick Bonino with his first goal as a New York Ranger.
You want me to do it? Bonino, 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 Bonino. Bonino!
There you go. I knew you could do it. Turnover by the Bruins. And Bonino just picks it up, turns, and fires. Forward with an attempted pass. And then it goes off the stick because of the pressure of Will Cooley on Beecher. And Bonino picks it up, fires it home, and scores his first as a Ranger.
There you go. Nick Bonino.
I don't know what you were so worried about with that call.
I was afraid my tongue might get stuck on the top of my mouth. Nick Bonino has scored his first as a Ranger. Rangers lead the Bruins 1-0.
Forward, hard around the board, stopped by Panarin. Makes a move against Zaka. Outside, Gustafson. Shot toward the net, same turn, holding. It's put in by Chris Kreider. Chris Kreider, it's a power play goal. And the Rangers have a 2-0 lead.
Shot to the net, and I believe that was deflected on the way in, and that gave Allmark a little bit of a problem. Didn't get all of it, slither through him, Kreider finds it, and the Rangers lead it 2-0.
Kreider's seventh power play goal of the season. That now breaks a tie he had with three other players for the league lead. Were 1-for-3 yesterday. They're 1-for-their-last-8 over the last 3 games. Face-off win by Zaka. Bruins set up. Rangers penalty killing has been outstanding. A huge factor in yesterday's win. Truba hits Kreider. Kreider breaks in and scores! A shorthanded goal for Chris Kreider. Second goal of the game. Rangers lead again, 3-2.
What a pass coming up from Truba. McAvoy, the turnover, and Truba head up all the way. Leads Kreider beautifully. And once Kreider has a step on anybody, they're not going to catch him. And here he goes. Now he can take his time. That quick release just inside the post. And that gets his place going again. Standing ovation. Boy, what a first period this has been.
Chris Kreider with his 13th goal of the season. The league leader is Nikita Kucherov of the Tampa Bay Lightning with 15. Pass by Beecher. Got his left leg in front of it. Back pass to Schneider. Looks for a lane. Goes to Zach Jones.
Penalty coming up against Mitchell.
Oh, Schneider just missed on a deflection try.
Mitchell high stick Jimmy Vesey in front of the net.
The late penalty coming up on the Bruins. Rangers get an extra skater on. Played ahead by Panarin. Trocheck leaves it for Zach Jones. Beecher on him. Jones winds it deep all the way around to Panarin. Out of the corner, Vesey saved by Omar. Rangers keep it alive. Schneider with room. Panarin, the other side. Trocheck save. Omar, they score on the rebound. Jimmy Vesey, who drew the original penalty, stayed with it and scores the goal to give the Rangers the lead.
Just relentless play on the puck. They wouldn't let the Bruins get to the loose puck. Jimmy Vesey in front. Again, the Bruins don't get control of the puck. Pitlick does a good job. by all six. Beautiful save by Allmark on the Trocheck shot. And Jimmy Vesey, who was cut on the lip with the high stick, ends up putting it in. Well, we have seen just about everything in this game.
Truba behind the net by DeAndre Miller. Truba around the Miller. 30 seconds to go in the period. Long pass to Kreider. Kreider with Zibanejad. Zibanejad to Miller. He scores! Great puck movement, and what a shot by DeAndre Miller. Rangers lead 5-3.
This all starts from behind the Rangers net. Truba's going to make a little pass. He gets hit, and now DeAndre Miller starts it, and then he'll finish it. He doesn't stop, and Zibanejad knew that Miller was with him. He'll make a subtle little backhand pass right there, and Miller drills it home. So Truba starts it. Miller follows it up after he makes a long pass, and in about 5 seconds, the Rangers put it in down the other end.
There's a long way to go in the game, as Joe mentioned before. This is the third time in the last four games the Bruins have given up 5 goals in the game, Joe.
That's crazy.
There's a quick shot that was stopped by BC, and the rebound put in!
Right off the faceoff, Jimmy Vesey will get the shot, and he'll end up with a pass right there. Gets the shot, follows it up. Goodrow is taking one man out. Pitlick just goes to the front of the net. And this line, they've been talked about an awful lot lately by the head coach. And for good reason.
Earlier in the game, Nick Bonino had his first goal as a New York Ranger. That was Tyler Pitlick's first goal as a New York Ranger. Now, I can't do the same Pitlick.
You can.
Bonino.
You can try.
I don't think it works.
You can try.
But the Rangers get the first goal of the third period, and saved by Omar. There's a lot of room to make moves.
Or they're turning.
Panarin scores! All I had to do was say that he hadn't scored a point in 3 games. That's all it takes. Artemi Panarin makes it 7-4. Rangers.
All right, this is just go, go, go. 1-on-3, Trocheck forces Omar to make that save, and the Rangers end up with the puck, and Schneider will find Panarin with that cross-ice pass. Schneider head up all the way, beautiful pass. No chance for Omar to get to the other side. And Panarin, who had a glorious chance right at the start of the period, scores the 7th for the Rangers.
It's the Rangers have had 40 shots in the game. They're on their feet at the Garden, cheering a big win for the New York Rangers. 7-4, they beat the Bruins. Panarin laughing. He had a lot of chances. Jonathan Quick is now 6-0-1. What a start to his Rangers career.
Yeah, well, we said it before, he's becoming a real story in the National Hockey League. This wasn't an easy game. You know, the goals that were scored on him, he didn't have much of a chance. He wanted the one from Pasternak back on the power play, but Pasternak's a special goal scorer. But this was just a, you talk about entertaining. Up and down the ice, the coaches will say, well, we didn't defend as well as we do, but this was just hard fought throughout. Nick Bonino gets his first goal as a Ranger. That's a good sign. The fourth line comes up big again. Jimmy Vesey was terrific in this game.
Tyler Pitlick with a goal.
There's Mika blowing you a kiss.
I think it might have been to Chris Kreider for scoring 2 goals. But the Rangers, they were ready to play. That's one thing you can say about the Rangers.
They always
games.
Are. No, they are.
Every
their,
game.
Their first periods, they have been coming out all season long. But very few times that I can remember where the first period where they've been sluggish or not skating or not moving or not putting pressure on. And, you know, they just after that tough, they had a tough game in Philadelphia yesterday. Boston had a tough game at home and losing to Detroit. And the Rangers came out with the first 8 shots in this one. Boston didn't have a shot until about the 12-minute mark.
And now it's time for the Mercedes-Benz Stars of the Game. Third star, Keandre Miller. Boy, he scored a beautiful goal.
Yeah, it turned out to be the game winner. His goal. Started it, followed it up on the play. He and Trouba have just been a really solid pair on defense.
Number 2 star, Jimmy Vesey. Another outstanding effort for him. A goal and an assist.
You know, Sammy's starting to make more plays with the puck. They're not just out there thinking defense and not contributing offensively. Now Jimmy Vesey's kind of leading the way for that line, taking it to the net, getting shots, holding onto the puck, making plays.
And Chris Kreider hears the cheers, the ovation from the crowd. A 2-goal game plus an assist. The Rangers this season have had a 6-game winning streak, a 4-game winning streak, and now a 3-game winning streak. They've won 7 of their last 8. They are 13-1-1 in their last 15. 7-4, Rangers win it. We'll be right back.
He gets it back from DeBrusk. Waves it around. Forbert, a touch pass. Saka leaves it in the circle. And Nick Bonino gets his first goal of the season. The Bruins were plagued by costly turnovers yesterday, and they begin a Saturday in the same fashion.
That's a nice pass, though. When you take a look at the replay, Derek Forbert on his backhand, you could feel the pressure coming down the wall. Used the middle of the ice because it was open. John Beecher just didn't hit on the puck. And even with Bonino spinning from that distance, almost working his way away from the Bruin goal, Omark is deep in his goal, not expecting that turnover and that quick kind of shot by Bonino, and it beats him on the stick side.
13:54 to go, first period. Nick Bonino, the veteran, cashing in. Panarin's stick. Forbert tries to clear. Kreider, a load, checked out of the way by Carlo. Panarin gives it back to Gustafsson, and a score by Crowder. Kreider, as the puck leaked through Ullmark. It's 2-0 Rangers.
Yeah, and you got to give Panarin a nice assist on this play. You know, Carlo makes a nice play behind the net. He forces Kreider, creates the turnover, pins him against the wall. And the wraparound by Forbert was a good read by Panarin. He seals off the wall. I mean, Forbert didn't rip it, but Panarin was where he needed to be to keep the play alive and keep the pressure on Boston. You get it back to the middle point. The shot from Gustafsson is on target. It gets all the way to Ullmark, who makes the save, but it squeezes through his body. We talked about Kreider and the living that he makes in the blue paint. There it is again. Tap in for an empty netter, power play goal, extends the lead.
The power play was presented by Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Bruins play that low, high, high, low game, and it leads to the power play opportunity when Zaka got hooked by Gustafsson.
9 power play goals for the Bruins in their last 9 games. Pasternak whips it toward goal. McAvoy paddles it off the boards. Chris Kreider looking for a second shorty, and he's got it.
since October of 2021, Kreider leads the league in shorthanded goals.
It's a great pass off a good bounce for the Rangers. McAvoy's just trying to go down the wall. It deflects. And Kreider just took a chance. I'm going to just keep going. He must have sensed that maybe that bounce will favor the Rangers and you'll get possession. So he flies the zone. And what a perfect pass. Tape to tape, in flight.
Zach Jones into the middle, and Schneider backdoor. Boston has a penalty coming. The extra skater on for the Broadway Blues. Zach Jones touched away by Beecher. No possession. Panarin deep for Vesey along the goal line. Schneider to Panarin. Bonus. Vesey. The Bruins, with the goalie pulled for the opposition, have misery getting the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, well, the delayed penalty was going to be on Ian Mitchell for a high stick and his battle to defend in front of the net. I mean, this is a pretty impressive play right there to score the goal. First of all, Vesey just kind of chops down on a rolling puck, knowing he really doesn't have time to handle it. But the Rangers' ability to maintain possession, and look, when the Bruins had an opportunity, their puck retrieval was very good. See Vesey getting attended to. I think he was the one that got high stick by Ian Mitchell.
Keandre Miller, the former Wisconsin Badger. Zibanejad to Miller! He scores! Only his second goal of the season, his first goal in 11 games, and it comes in the closing seconds of the second period.
Yeah, can't get beat up the ice. Another thing that Jim Montgomery talked about is goals late in periods or early. Those are all part of details as well. And the Rangers basically make this a 4-on-3 rush. DeAndre Miller made the pass from deep in his own zone. He just kind of drifts up the ice. He gets into a one-timer position. And he drifts one high glove side. Late second period goal. You know, you give up that shorthanded goal, that hurt. Now you give up a late second period goal, and that really hurts because now you're down by a pair. From the right defense, from the offensive blue line, they can't get numbers there.
Pitlick scores from Vesey. First goal in 13 games for Tyler Pitlick, and it's his first of the season.
Yeah, it's just loose coverage, bad decisions, no layers. You know, you're thinking we got to get two goals, and you start drifting and you start waiting for somebody to get you the puck. Now you're not in position to defend. I mean, think about it, Jack. You know, they gave up 5 to Tampa. They had a nice bounce back game against Florida, then 5 more to Detroit. They've already given up 6 today. You know, that's not a top defensive team in the NHL.
Yep. Trocheck with speed and a backhand saved by Ullmark. Zach Jones, Braden Schneider, Panarin scores on a one-timer. The Rangers kick the extra point.
Well, the breakdowns continue in the defensive zone for the Boston Bruins. Panarin's left wide open on the dot. And it's just a basic little seam pass. Here come the Rangers again in transition. Easy entry into the zone. Penetrate deep. Now they play that low-high game. The D get involved. Everybody's looking at the puck, and nobody's picking up the open man. Or not enough of them. And Panarin wastes no time with the one-timer on the feed from Schneider.
Lafreniere on the boards. And the clock mercifully runs out. Save of the game brought to you by TD Bank.
Well, after the timeout, just to catch you up, and you know, the Bruins are down 2-0. Timeout. Coach gets the players' attention, and the Bruins score quickly twice to make it 2-2, and they got the momentum and the pressure, and Heinen gets an unbelievable chance from the slot. I mean, that makes it 3-2, and there's all kinds of doubt in the New York Rangers. Probably the biggest save of the afternoon for Jonathan Quick. Came at a time where his team needed it. He delivered. And then the Rangers had some fun the rest of the way.
The Rangers leapfrogged the Bruins in the Eastern Conference and overall NHL standings. The Bruins head to Columbus. Join Sophia as she conducts the post-mortem for Andy Brinkley and Andrew Raycroft. I'm Jack Edwards. The final, the Rangers 7, the Bruins 4.